Hello everyone, welcome to part 15 of Laravel 11 series, in which we are creating the e-commerce website with Laravel as well as the MongoDB. And we will once again work on updating the admin details. And in this video, we are going to update the admin image via intervention packet. So first thing is that we are going to install the intervention package. And once again, I will show you the steps that we are going to take in this video. And the first step is that we are going to install the intervention package, okay? So we are going to add this package, intervention image 2.7 version in composer.json, and here we are going to add it here, okay? So after adding this, we are going to run the composer update command. So I'm going to search for my project htdocs, and here is my project 11. Right click services, new terminal, add folder. In Windows, that how you can run the composer commands in your project. I hope that you know that how to run the composer command for your Laravel project. Okay, so just simply run the composer update, because we have updated the composer JSON, so that it will download the intervention package that we require for uploading the images in Laravel. Uploading, not only uploading, but also we can resize the images in Laravel with the intervention package. Okay, so see, it has been done, and after installing the package, now we are able to use it as well. And I'm going to close this file, and we'll update. I'll open here the update admin details that we have created in the last video, update admin details. Okay, so in this file, I'm going to add enctype form data. Okay, so we are going to add this enctype form data. We are going to add here with the form. Okay, so here it is. So to add the images, to upload the images, we are required this syntax enctype multipart form data. And after adding this, we are going to add the other code. And after, so this step we are going to take later on, but first of all, we will try to upload the image. We are going to debug that the image is coming there or not. Okay, so once again, I am going to check in admin controller here that the image is coming here or not. Okay, so let's see. I'm going to refresh here, and sorry, not update password. I'm going to use here the update. Sorry, I'm going to close this one, and we'll open this one, update admin details, the form that we have added in the last video. And here now I'm going to choose the file as well, any of the file I'm going to choose from my folder, like I'm going to choose some file, some image, in fact I can choose. Okay, so this is the image that I'm going to choose, MongoDB image, and we'll click on submit to see the okay, it is showing that it has been updated, but actually sorry, we have wrong place this debug. Okay, so just command this one and open that function that we have added in the last video. This is the command that we are required to use. Okay, so once again, I'm going to choose that MongoDB image. Here it is. So I'm going to choose and submit. See, the image is coming fine here. Okay, so now we can able to write the code, and we are already having this code, upload image code. This is the code that we are going to add here. After the validate, we are going to add this upload image code. Okay, so here you can see, first it will check that the image is coming or not. If the image is coming, then we are going to check that the image is valid or not. And if the image is valid, then we are going to get the extension of the image, and we will make the new image name, and we will set the path as well. This is the path, admin images photos. So here in our folder, we are going to create the folder public admin images, and inside images I'm going to create another folder, photos folder, so that we can store the admin images in this folder. Okay, inside this folder we're going to store the admin images, and its path is given here. And finally, we are going to upload the admin image in this path. Okay, so if there is the update, okay, if the admin wants to update the image, so we are going to take the current image. We are going to add the syntax here, like in the case of edit, this must work fine as well. So this is the code. Like if there is if image is not empty, it means that the image is already uploaded. So in that case, we have the condition here. Okay, so we are going to check whether the image is empty or not, whether there is already admin image exists or not. If the admin image is not empty, means if the admin image is already exist, then we are going to show that view image, okay, so that the admin can able to click and can view that image. And also we are going to put that image in the current image hidden variable, okay, hidden field. So we have added this hidden field, and this will come into play only when we are going to when we will try to update the image, not for adding the image, it's for the updating the image. Means image is already there, admin image is already there, and we want to update it. So in that case, see, old image means current image we are going to put inside this, so that we can have the current image here in case the admin will not update the image, don't want to update the image, and just want to update the name or mobile. In that case, we will just take the current image of the admin and will have it in the file name. Okay, so you can see file name, file name, file name. File name is in the three conditions. First condition is when the admin adds the image, this is the file name of that particular image, and when the admin updates, when the admin updates the name or mobile but without the image, then we are going to pick the current image and we'll save that in the file name. And if the admin will not do anything, then the file name is empty. Okay, so this one we are going to save it in here as well. Okay, so here I think it's we have given in the code as well. So image we are going to save after this one. We are going to save the image as well, image dollar file name. Okay, and after that we will redirect the user back to that admin, update admin details. So this is the code, and also we are going to update the sidebar as well. So first we are going to check this one. Like I'm going back here, refresh, and we'll see that if I able to update the admin image or not. Okay, so here like I'm going to add this one, click on submit. Here we are going to comment this one. So let's see now, click on continue. And okay, so here we need to add the package that use image. We need to add it like use image for the intervention package, and then continue once again. And here you can see that we able to upload the image. Okay, so finally we able to update upload the image as well. Okay, so now we are going to update the sidebar as well. Okay, so here you can see that we want to show the sidebar here, the admin image as well as the admin name as well. Here you can see admin image as well as the name. So I'm going to open the sidebar, and here in the name we are going to pick the name, the current admin name, and we'll simply paste it here. And it's coming in the auth guard, you can see it's coming admin. Okay, and for the image we will add the condition that if the image is coming, then we are going to show that image, otherwise we will not show. Okay, so that we are going to add here where it is div class image div class image where it is, and here it is. Okay, here now see now we're going to check yes, so it's coming here. Okay, the image that we have added, it's coming here as well, and also the name of the admin, image of the admin as well as the name of the admin is coming here. The pass are also correct, update password as well as the update details. Okay, both are working fine. So everything is working fine here. We can see that we able to complete this update password as well as the update admin details. And in the next video we will keep doing further things in our e-commerce website, and we'll see the new things for the MongoDB as well. Okay, so that's all for now. And also I want to show you one thing here. Now image must be image in here for this one, admin@admin.com. I'm going to refresh and you can see the image name here. Okay, so it's updating as well. MongoDB is updating as well as per according to the updates that we are doing in the admin panel. Okay, so please stay tuned for the next video. That's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.